Okay, so before we begin, I know what you're thinking. Yes, Batman is my favorite superhero, but don't worry, I'm not one of those fanboys going around attacking people just because they don't agree with him. So, as long as you have your own opinion, that's fine. Just make sure you realize that you're wrong. Okay, so with the jokes out of the way, you might have seen the title to this video and think to yourself, that's not right. I mean, Batman doesn't have any superpowers, but that doesn't necessarily make him that realistic. And don't worry, I'm well aware of the laws of physics and biology. I know how unrealistic he is. But I'm not talking about how realistic he is. I'm talking about how realistic his philosophy is. Now, before I get into that, let's go over why Batman is my favorite superhero. And don't worry, I promise you this is not just me fanboying. I mean, okay, it is a little bit, but I promise you I'm getting to a point here, so just stick with me on this one, okay? Now, one thought you might have is, oh, it's just because he doesn't have any superpowers but is still a superhero. Well, that's a small part of it, admittedly, but that's not the main reason. I mean, think about it. If that were the case, there'd be a lot of other superheroes much higher up on my personal list. For example, Hawkeye, Green Arrow, Nightwing, Batgirl, Robin, Karate Kid. Yes, there's a Karate Kid in the DC Universe. No, I'm not talking about the one from the series of films you're probably familiar with. Wildcat, The Punisher, the original Blue Beetle, the one before he had the alien device attached to his back. Huntress, Iron Man, War Machine, and Alfred, which I know some people don't count as an actual superhero, but considering he punched out Superman with just his fist, I'm counting him! Whew! Sorry about that. Forgot to breathe. And you know what? I actually forgot to mention Batdog. He's in there too. But point is, even though I like just about everybody on this list, I don't necessarily hold any of them as high as I do Batman, except for maybe Alfred. I mean, seriously, he's pretty underrated. But point being, as you can see, even though it is a small part of it, the fact that he doesn't have superpowers isn't really the main reason Batman's one of my favorite superheroes. So you might be thinking, so, but like, what else is there? That's kind of all he's got going for him. Is it because he's rich and has a lot of trinkets and high-tech gadgets? If that were the case, Iron Man would take this place, because I think we can all see Iron Man has a much larger focus on technology and, finding ridiculous ways to spend money. Now, don't get me wrong, I still really like Iron Man. It's not like I hate the guy. I really like him, especially after the movies, and I've even seen the TV shows, so I do really like Iron Man. But he's nowhere near as high as I hold Batman. Why is that? Well, that actually leads me to the entire point of this video. It's because Batman has the most realistic philosophy. Now, like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, that does not mean Batman himself is realistic. It's because his philosophy is realistic. So, let me explain what I mean by this. See, in the real world, get ready for a shocker, people have weaknesses. Now, I would like to tell you I'm an exception to this rule, but I cannot do that honestly. We all have weaknesses, and I think just about all of us have realized that by this point in our lives. Unless you're a newborn, in which case I have absolutely no idea how you're watching this video. But if you have the mental capacity of anybody over the age of, say, 5 or so, you've probably realized this. Now, a lot of us have a tendency to pretend that we just don't have these weaknesses. And when we do that, it generally comes back to bite us in the keister at one point or another. This is where Batman's philosophy comes in. See, I believe that Batman's philosophy is not only the most realistic philosophy to use, but it's also the best way to solve this, in my opinion. See, the thing you have to realize about Batman is that he is by far one of the weakest superheroes in his entire world. Yet somehow, he is quite possibly the only superhero capable of beating every other superhero up. And I'm not just talking about Superman, because as strong as he is, grab yourself a green rock or a red flashlight, you're good to go. But I'm talking Martian Manhunter, Wonder Woman, Green Lantern, Flash, Dr. Fate, Shazam, we can go on and on and on. Point is, he can and has beaten all of these superheroes while still being one of the weakest ones there. So, this brings us to the philosophy and using it to answer, how is it that Batman's able to pull this off? Well, the simple answer is that he's a lot smarter than everybody else by far. And you're not wrong. That's completely fine to answer, and it's the simplest, quickest way to answer this question, but I want to go deeper into it. See, We know that, of course, Batman has a fair bit of weakness when compared to a lot of the other superheroes. But he doesn't just ignore his weakness and go head first. But he also doesn't despair over it. I know that there's a lot of memes going out there with Batman being all like, "Oh, Batman's the big sad because he doesn't have soupy powers." Not that I have anything against those memes. I'm entertained by a lot of them. But ultimately, they don't really represent Batman as he's written. Batman as he's written doesn't dwell over the fact that he doesn't have superpowers. So, this brings us to using philosophy to answer the question, how is it that Batman's able to pull this off? So, what happens here is that Batman takes note of his weaknesses, and he generally does one of two things. He either strengthens himself to improve on that area, or he finds a way around it, which is usually what he does. But we're going to start with the first point. He strengthens himself to the absolute peak. Now, even if your only exposure to Batman are the Justice League movies, which, again, are not great representations of Batman, you know that Batman does constant training to make himself as strong as humanly possible. But it doesn't end there. Batman's a master in just about every martial arts known to man. Now, this fact changes from version to version. There are some versions where it turns out Batman just went to one school, but the school was like the best possible school in the entire world, and he was one of the best students there. But one way or the other, he is a master in martial arts far beyond even your average martial artist in that world. Now, that might seem trivial when you're fighting people who are flying and can shoot laser beams out of their eyes, but when Batman uses it, because he finds a way to effectively use it, he makes it work. Now, obviously, Batman would be able to take out some of the lower-powered superheroes and villains. For instance, if he were ever to face off against Black Canary, my money's on Batman. But it doesn't stop there. There have been instances where he's able to use just martial arts to beat even some more higher-leveled opponents. For instance, I can't remember the exact name of this villain, but he was a villain from the Phantom Zone. Don't worry if you don't know what that is. If you do, great. If you don't, just know that it's a place where powerful people come from. A villain came from the Phantom Zone, had, I believe, super strength, an axe, and a couple magical-based powers that are a little hard to describe. Batman spent 3 minutes using a judo-style hip throw to toss him around. And I don't mean it took him 3 minutes to do it. I meant he spent 3 minutes continuously doing it over and over and over again. That is how well he's able to use it. And it doesn't stop there. Batman is arguably one of the best ninjas ever. And people don't realize this. When I say ninja, I don't mean he fights like a cinematic ninja. What I mean is, he does that, and he has all of the skills an actual ninja would have. I'm talking chemistry knowledge, I'm talking stealth capability, I'm talking disguises, everything that you could think a ninja could do, Batman can do. In fact, let me show you this scene.
Noticed, but fire's no problem for me. As I was saying, Green Lantern can do anything.
Except shut up, apparently.
Wow, someone forgot to take their true blood tonight.
I'm not a vampire.
Seriously? I thought with the darkness and the vanishing, then the what, super strength?
No.
Can you fly?
In a plane.
Wait, you're not just some guy in a bat costume, are you? Are you freaking kidding me? What? Nobody asked you to prom, so now you dress as a bat and prowl around your parents' basement?
What's this do?
Huh?
No buttons. I assume it works off concentration.
How'd you do that?
You weren't concentrating.
You won't do that again.
Unless I want to.
That's it! Let's rumba, Spooky!
Now, in case you don't know and didn't get it from that video, the ring Batman took is the source of a Green Lantern's power. It allows them to manifest virtually anything, and it's as strong as their will is. Not going to get into how that works. Point being, Batman took it quite easily and only threatened him after he gave him back the ring. And that's only one of the many ninja skills Batman possesses. I could sit here for like 20 minutes going over all of the ninja skills Batman has. Now, I'm not going to do that because that's not the point of this video, but if you're interested, a YouTuber by the name of Gaijin Goomba actually did the research to tell you how realistic of a ninja Batman is. I'll leave it down in the description below. But I'm going off the rails here. Point being that Batman has strengthened himself both skillfully and physically to the peak of human physical ability. And realistically speaking, this is what we have to do with ourselves. If we are not strong enough, we train to become stronger. If we are not fast enough, we train to become faster. This is what we must do to overcome our own weaknesses in real life, not a comic book. Now, with that said, like I mentioned before, this isn't always a viable option for Batman. Just like in real life, sometimes we can't do that. For instance, let's say I lose an arm. No amount of training is going to allow me to grow back my arm. Maybe if there's a medical miracle at some point, sure, but until then, you're not getting back that arm. Now, to most people, you might say, well, that's it. There's no way to do what it is I want to do. Batman doesn't even consider that possibility. To him, anytime somebody mentions anything like that, he smirks, looks at them, and says, "Watch me." And that brings us to our next point. Batman is fully aware that no matter how much he trains, no matter how many steroids he takes, which, to be clear, he's never really taken any steroids, at least not intentionally. But even if he wanted to go down that route, he could take every steroid available, and he'd still never, ever amount to the power that his comrades have. Now, if you're a normal person like me, that was extremely depressing. If you're Batman, that's just another Tuesday. You see, Batman recognizes his weaknesses, sometimes to strengthen them, but not always. And it's certainly not so that he can sulk over them either. It's so that he can think to himself, okay, what am I going to do about it? Now, the first very most common way he compensates for this is quite obviously by his gadgets. Thanks to the menagerie of technology and weaponry he has around his waist, he is able to go toe-to-toe with some of the most powerful villains in the entire DC universe. Between his combustion pellets, his grappling hook, and several other things I don't even know about. I could sit here for, like, again, 20 minutes telling you about the things I do know about and still not cover everything he has in his belt. Oh, and quick side note, I need to fanboy a little bit here. People make the argument, oh, well, he has all these high-tech gadgets on his belt, so it's super easy for him. Okay, look, these things that he usually has on his belt, most of them exist in the real world. Like, a lot of the stuff that he has on his belt and 99% of the stuff he uses on a regular basis exists in the real world. But you don't see anybody pulling this off because it's not easy. For anybody to pull this kind of stuff off, you have to have extreme skill to be able to implement all of these tools. I mean, just look at the Batarang. That alone requires extreme skill and technique. Now, if we were talking about the Iron Man suit, that's a different story, because that's a fully automated piece of hardware that more or less runs itself and you just kind of give it commands. Which, again, not dissing the Iron Man suit. I love the Iron Man suit, but point being that the gadgets that Batman usually uses does not make the job easy for him. He just makes it look easy. Now, back to the original video. This is not where it stops. Batman, of course, has a whole other set of technologies. The car that can sometimes, depending on what series you're watching, transform into a giant robot, which he has used multiple times. The stealth plane, the boat. I could go on and on and on. Point is that gadgets is how he usually compensates for it. Now, again, the gadgets don't necessarily mean it's making it easy for him, especially when he's going up against super-powered enemies, But he uses them to compensate for the fact that he is not as powerful as everybody else. But it does not stop there. Because, surprise, the gadgets don't always work. In fact, I argue, 30% of the time they're pretty much useless in the scenarios that he gets put in. Now, again, if you were a normal person, you'd be desperate. But if you're Batman, that's just your Thursdays. And this is where we get to my favorite part of Batman. His mind. Not only does he qualify for a PhD in pretty much every science known to man and a couple not known to man, but on top of that, I would qualify him as the equivalent of what would be a grandmaster chess player. Now, don't get me wrong, there are other superheroes that are really smart. Immediate thought that comes to mind, Firestorm. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, at least half of him, because he's kind of two humans put into one to make a superhero, is a, I believe, a professional chemist or physicist. I think that kind of changes depending on what series you watch. But point being, they generally only specialize in one or a couple of the sciences. They really don't branch out that wide. And even when they do, that usually is the trade-off for actual street smarts. Batman doesn't have this problem. Not only is he, again, familiar with every science known to man, and again, a couple that aren't known to man, but on top of that, Batman is extremely street smart. He's extremely familiar with how the underground works. And then on top of all that, one of his, I think, most studied sciences is probably going to be psychology. That's why he's able to figure out people so well. And the reason Batman's mind is like this is because he knows that he's not going to be able to compete with the supervillains head on like the other superheroes can. So his best option is to go the other way around. He optimized his mind to an almost inhuman level. This is what allows Batman to go head-to-head with every single superhero and villain. In fact, he even has contingency plans for every single member of the Justice League, and he has successfully implemented all of them from time to time. So he definitely can take these guys down. And in the recent Justice League series, there was even an entire episode dedicated to Batman competing against the smartest villains and heroes for survival, and unsurprisingly, Batman's the one to get him out of that situation. But just like in real life, he knows he can't do it traditionally. See, in the real world, there are going to be instances where we cannot win using traditional methods. It does not matter how much you train. It does not matter how much you really want it. You're just not going to be able to do it. But that doesn't mean you can't win. You just have to find a different way to do it. And that's what Batman does. He doesn't sulk on the fact that he doesn't have powers. He doesn't sulk on the fact that everybody else is more fortunate than he is. He knows that. But that doesn't stop him. He just says, well, gotta think of something else. And he does. And just to fanboy a little bit here, Batman does this to the extreme. Martial arts don't work, don't worry, he's got gadgets. Gadgets don't work, don't worry, he's got science. Science don't work, don't worry, he already put a plan in motion 3 months ago to have his friend brainwashed, lead the battle, have himself intentionally captured, have his friend go into depression, get out of depression, assemble the team he already preached, come save him, and fix the timeline before any of that even happened. What? Checkmated before the board's even set. Now, don't get me wrong. Again, I reiterate, there are plenty of other heroes that rely on their intelligence and because of it are very formidable threats. Iron Man, Mr. Fantastic, Firestorm, Ant-Man. Not necessarily the one from the movies, but the one people are more familiar with prior to that. Not that there's anything wrong with the movies. I really love the Ant-Man movies. He's just not the example I'm looking for, but I'm digressing. Point being is that there are other very intelligent superheroes. The thing is that they really only specialize in that area of intelligence. In Tony's case, it's primarily robotics with some genetics and time travel for some reason mixed in. With Firestorm, it's chemistry and or physics. And it's true that there are plenty of heroes that kind of just encompass most of science. But the thing that sets Batman different from those heroes is that their specialties kind of just stay within that area of science. When it comes to creativity, they're very, very, very creative in their respective fields. Out of them, they're not necessarily terrible. In a lot of cases, even out of their fields, they're extremely creative, but not to the extent where it's their specialty. With Batman, it kind of is. Now, obviously, we're not going to be mind-controlling or time-traveling, or at least as far as I know, anyways. But what's realistic about what Batman does is, again, his philosophy. The first thing to reiterate is that he makes himself stronger. If somebody is stronger than him initially, he will train to overcome that. He will become stronger, faster, and more skilled. But in his world, just like often in our world, that's just not going to cut it. It's kind of like I said earlier, you can cut off an arm no matter how much you train, unless we have some revolution in genetics, you're not going to grow a new one. So you can train as much as you want, it's not going to regrow the arm. And in Batman's case, it's not going to give him superpowers. But that doesn't mean he can't win. Just because he's not going to be able to magically manifest superpowers doesn't mean he is doomed. He knows this, and he doesn't let the fact that everybody else has an initial advantage bother him. He takes advantage of what he does have and finds a way around his problem. He finds a very unconventional and never before thought of way to be able to keep up, to the point where he turns from one of the weakest characters in his universe to by far the most feared and threatened. Just to show you an example of what I mean, check this out.
This one has cheated us many times. It is vexing.
Boo.
Now, one note I want to make really quickly, because man, this video is going way longer than I initially wanted to, is that I'm fully aware that there are other characters that can definitely give Batman a run for his money. Nick Fury from Marvel, Light Yagami from Death Note, and Joseph Joestar from JoJo's Bizarre Adventures. And quick side note, could you just imagine if any of these guys got into a chess match? It would be hilarious and awesome to watch. But I'm digressing again. Anyways, the reason I really didn't include them in this video is because, in my opinion, their philosophies are a smidge different, which isn't necessarily bad by any means. It just really didn't fit into this video because I was focusing on Batman's philosophy and how it can apply to the real world. But, you know, I'm actually thinking about doing a video on one or two of those characters, so stay tuned for that. And, you know, if you stayed this long and hopefully don't hate me, please subscribe and leave a comment as to who your favorite character is and why. Otherwise, make sure to hit that bell button. I post every other week, and until then, hear nothing and listen to all. Bye, guys!